Chapter 4, Section 4.1, Defining the Atom. This section is going to give us a little bit of background on the atom. Tomorrow in class, I'll show you a video that's called The Powers of 10. It'll help you understand the magnitude of the different powers. The early models of the atoms. The first guy that you should know is Democritus. He's a Greek fellow. And as you probably know, atomos is where we got the word atom. And he said that atoms are indestructible and indivisible. The time period was about 400 BC. Democritus could not explain chemical changes. It took about 2,000 years for John Dalton to arrive on the scene. It's about 1766 when he was born. He was doing his work in about 1780. And he thought a lot about atoms. He was a school teacher in England, an area called the Lake District. He eventually moved to Manchester and became a member of the Manchester Literary and Philosophical Society. This gave him access to it. Laboratory where he could do his own experiments. He thought a lot about atoms. He was one of the first to give us symbols. So he had these circles with either letters or different figures in them to identify different elements. But do notice that some of these are not elements, such as, let's get a highlighter, lime, potash, but most of the others are elements. Dalton's atomic theory has five parts to it. He said all elements are composed of tiny, indivisible particles called atoms. There we go. So there's atoms of element A. The second bit, atoms of the same element are identical. Atoms of any one element are different from those of any other element. And we have a picture of atoms of element B. Two different sizes for A and B, two different colors to help you identify them. Third part of his theory, atoms of different elements can physically mix together or can chemically combine in simple whole number ratios to form compounds. So John Dalton is beginning to explain how elements can form compounds. A simple whole number ratio. Think about H2O, two hydrogens to one oxygen. That's a simple whole number ratio. Page to turn. Let's try it this way. There we go. Here we just have a physical mixture of the atoms. Notice they're not touching each other. They're not chemically combined. Here, or his fourth point in his theory, chemical reactions occur when atoms are separated, joined, or rearranged. Atoms of one element are never changed into atoms of another element in a chemical reaction. So notice that now we have two A's for every one B. This is what the water molecule looks like. So John Dalton in the 18th century began to define the atom a little bit more and helped us to understand chemical reactions just a little bit. Today, we can see atoms with a scanning tunneling microscope. This is a picture or a micrograph of iron. Again, these points are where the iron atoms are. This microscope was developed by IBM scientists in the 80s. That's it for lecture one. A little bit more in lecture two.